It may look virtually identical to the Sony Xperia Z, but the Sony Xperia Z1 is a very different bit of kit. We're going to kick off telling you about the design, and it feels way more premium in the hand. Why? Because it's made from a single piece of metal. Constructed with a unibody design, it feels much, much more robust. You've got a glass front and back, which is scratch resistant, although admittedly, we have scuffed it a little bit since getting it. Another key difference is you've got a physical camera button in the bottom right-hand corner. All in all, it does feel like a better phone. It's a little bit sharp, it's a little bit thicker as well, but when we come onto the specs, you're going to see exactly why. Moving on to the display, and Sony touts their new tri-luminous display technology on the 5-inch full HD display. Now, the pixel density is astounding, 441 ppi, and it's very responsive to the touch. Unfortunately, tri-luminous doesn't translate to a really great screen experience. It's a little bit washed out compared to other flagships, and viewing angles really aren't on point, which is a real shame considering the rest of the phone is so freaking good. And that's what we're going to come on to now. The user interface, for starters. With its Qualcomm Snapdragon 800 processor, it absolutely flies. Sony's UI is very, very tapered. It's Android through and through, Android 4.2, by the way, but it's a respectful bout of Android. You have themes, you have light customizations to it, but all the customizations are done well. Take the gallery, for example. This integrates all your photos in a much, much more attractive way than any other gallery UI. In addition, music and video is all integrated using Sony's entertainment network services, which we'll come on to a little bit later, but suffice to say, they add to the Android experience. The 20.7 megapixel camera is also astounding compared to that of the Xperia Z and most other flagships on the market, save for the Lumia 1020. That means it's very, very good, probably one of the best, if not the best, Android phones. It has a whole load of shooting modes, including Superior Auto, which will make all the decisions for you. You've also got AR effects, which is going to throw cool augmented reality effects like dinosaurs and little gnomes in your scene. It sounds a bit corny, but it's a lot of fun, keeping you entertained for hours. What's more, there's a social media sharing video app, so you can stream some video directly to Facebook, sharing it with your loved ones around the world. The full HD video is also pretty great on the noise handling and the detail front, so all in all, the camera experience is pretty much one of the best out there. Unfortunately, the same can't be said for multimedia. There are some really great points to talk about. It's got aptX support, so all you Bluetooth audiophiles are gonna love this thing. In addition, the Music Unlimited service is integrated into the entire UI, so if you're a member or you opt for a 60-day free trial, then it's gonna be a great music experience. Unfortunately, that screen really lets it down. The washed out viewing angles when you're watching movies just dampen the experience, and it's not quite as enjoyable reading ebooks on it, for example, as it would be on an LG G2 or an HTC One. The loudspeaker's also slightly underwhelming on the volume stakes. But do you know what? We might expect this based on the waterproofing of the phone. We didn't mention it when it came to the design, but this thing is waterproof and dust resistant. So it's going to offer something that none of the other smartphone flagships can. Throw in 4G, 3G, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and NFC in there, and it's very well connected. There's no IR blaster, but with a Sony Bravia TV, you'll be able to connect this thing over Wi-Fi direct, enabling you to have full control. The battery's 3000 milliamps as well, meaning that the Xperia Z's poor battery life is a thing of the past. The Z1 will easily last you a full day and you won't even have to turn on power stamina mode. If you do, you may get a day and a half to 2 days out of it, which is pretty impressive stuff. So all in all, the Xperia Z1 isn't without its issues, mainly that screen, but it's a fantastic device in pretty much all other areas.